I'm going now to share what I'm going to have for breakfast, which is gonna be simple, one toast and kiwi. But because now it's mid-morning, so it's before lunchtime, this kind of snack what I'm having. And when I took my son to school this morning, I took a banana. This is the bread that I'm going to use. I get it from Trader Joe's, and it has all types of seeds. And this peanut butter is unsalted. If you saw my last video, I'm really determined to avoid salt Monday through Friday. Okay, so I'm going to peel this kiwi now. You know that I was thinking earlier when I was on my way from the gym and I was getting home. I used to remember what kind of breakfast I used to have at the end of the year, no? So at the end of the year, for example, I was craving by this time of the day a hamburger with French fries or tuna melt with French fries, you know, all this greasy food. And the reason was because, unfortunately, for some reason, you know, when you are a mother and single mother, it is kind of hard, you know, sometimes because we have to do double the work. So for some reason, at the end of the day, I used to have a few glasses of wine. And then I started seeing on other moms, you know, on YouTube or magazines or commercials, that is kind of the in thing to do. Just have a glass of wine at the end of the day. So if, you know, by doing that, in the morning, you are not really craving this food. You are craving what I used to have, fat and fast food. So that's not good. So I was taking care of me, obviously, otherwise I would have been like 200 pounds right now. But you know, the energy is completely different because you don't feel with the same energy, neither emotionally, neither physical. So those few drinks at night when your kids are asleep, for example, that's what I used to do with when my son was asleep. It paid off, but just for the moment. So and the night flies by really quickly. So before you know it, you need to get up. You need to take your kids to school. And then it's a whole mess. You know, it's just like, you feel like, don't feel good with yourself because you're not getting up as happier in the morning and neither with the same energy. So I'm changing those routines. I mean, it's not that I was doing this every day, but I was doing it very often. So very often during the week. So what I said to myself right now is that no fast food, no salt, and no drinks. It completely changed, I don't know, because I did this before. But that's why I'm just saying, you know, not come good, I have a good here. It changed you, you know, you feel better, happier, and you see life in a different way. So that's why I'm very motivated, and I hope, you know, this is the point that I was trying to say, like, mind can trick you. Because during the day, if you're hungry, your mind will just make you see Carl's Jr., Taco Bell, you name it. So at night, at the end of the day, after working hard with your kids and doing whatever you have to do besides that, at the end of the day, your mind is gonna trick you and it's gonna make you see maybe a bottle of wine or whatever you like to drink to relax in the supermarket store, or not even seeing it, sometimes it's just in your mind, so you're just gonna say, I'm gonna go get it, just for tonight. And I used to say that, just for tonight. And just for tonight, once you open that door, it's very hard to close it. So I finally close it, and I'm guessing that this time is for good. It's not just for a period of time. I might take a glass of wine, maybe on the summer, or a beer, but that's it. That's it. Not anymore. So I do wanna be a healthy man. So it's very important for me to take care of me because I'm the only one that my son has, you know, and my son only has me. So if I don't take care of myself, forget it. So by these simple thoughts, you know, that are positive thinking, it helped me to make a decision and to say, well, this is what I'm going to avoid from now on. The beginning of the year kind of helped me in a way because I was ending the year thinking like this. So it's just like starting fresh, basically. So it doesn't really matter which month of the year or which day of the week you decide to start dieting or eating healthier. What it matters is that it's gonna last. Okay, so this is my breakfast. Very simple. Delicious too. Very good. Okay, so I guess I resume later. Because my son is coming very hungry when he comes from school. I'm going to add, I'm gonna put it all. He is going to be having rice with veggies and dumplings for lunch. So I'm going to steam these dumplings and then also the veggies and then rice, plain rice. That's it, simple. Go very minimum. You know, I'm a little bit off today. I don't know, low energy. I'm gonna, you know, try to overcome this feeling that I don't like to have. But the thing is that I've been thinking about my son's father this morning. And, well, I'm not gonna go there, but that kind of make me feel down, you know, just like, kind of low energy. Let me just have a mate and share a little bit. You know that I've been also, now that after I had my breakfast, I sat down and I had a few mates and I was, you know, just watching videos on the internet. And I went into one video that a man was talking about how men thinks about dating single mothers. So I was just reading the comments of that video. First of all, this man, it was very funny because he was very upset with the fact that dating a single mother, he was saying that is, we came with a lot of baggage more than the 737. That made me laugh. So it's been a long time that I don't fly, so I don't know how the airplane 737 gets loaded with baggage. It can be funny. I used to be flight attendant, so I know that airplane very well. I used to fly those airplanes as a stewardess. This man was saying, okay, so I was reading the comments and there are a lot of men in this video. I forgot the name. I was busy, you know, just also in my few minutes of break of doing things that I had to get done here in the house, I was reading that. So the point is this, for men that thinks that dating a single mother, all these negative things, that's my point of this. Like, I did not know how bad and wrong thinking men has for single mothers. Actually, let me just find the comments and I'll share it because this rice is gonna take a while. If it is true what he's saying, maybe obviously he's a man probably my age, on his 40s. So the way he's talking, first of all, I love it because he's talking like he knows everything. And he's right in a way. Obviously, a single mother, regardless the financial situation of the men that we can eventually meet, of course we wanted to lend the men. I mean, obviously, we have an issue here that is very serious. I mean, if I'm gonna date somebody, obviously I'm going to make sure that that man most likely is gonna marry me. I'm not gonna just be dating and introduce my son to a man that is gonna stay with me for a year or two, then we are both gonna love this man and then this man is gonna walk away. Okay, I can deal with the pain, but what about our kids? They will have to suffer once again, and remember that the first time they suffer is because their own father left them. So imagine introducing a man, your boyfriend, to a child, and then the child gets kind of the father figure and that father love that he's missing from his real father, and then this man walks away. I mean, regardless of the financial situation that we can find in a man, that's second. Priority number one is that to make sure that that man is gonna stay. I'm not gonna bother and date somebody that is not gonna marry me. See, I mean, I should have been born in Saudi Arabia. I mean, if you wanna date me, make sure that you sign the papers first. Date me meaning all the way, no, if you're gonna stay with me. So what he's saying is true, but in my point of view as a woman. So I remember the last time that I cried thinking about men. That was when I was 6 weeks pregnant with my son. My son now is 12 years old. So that was the last time that I cried because I remember going to sleep and I cried. I cried because I said, now my life is over. Now I will never find another man. Now I will never get married. Now I will never be with a man again. So obviously, once you become a mother, your child becomes the real love of your life. So we change our mentality because we're no longer looking for love. We already found it. So in my case, I'm talking about me, if I ever find a man, it will be like a partner, you know, like a friend. Obviously, the romantic part, who doesn't miss it? That's what I miss. Like, it's beautiful. It's one of the best stages in a woman's life, to be in love. And it's fun. But once you have a child, you know that that doesn't last too long. It ends too. So it's a lot, you know, it's just like a lot to talk about this subject, but I'm just sharing because mm-hmm. many things that single mothers, we are really hard to date. It's true. It is true. Sounds almost impossible. In my case, I don't even imagine. My son is 12, and I was thinking, you know, maybe when he's 14, I will date somebody who knows, I don't know when. I believe in destiny too. But if it didn't happen, it's because obviously I didn't have the time to meet anybody. Once you are a mother, you're always practically giving your life for your kids. Amazing, amazing. Oh yeah, because another thing that I was also reading, I don't know why men have this idea that women, we wanted to have a child in order to get child support. Child support is a minimum that the government gives us. Depending on, obviously, the job and the income of your ex-boyfriend or husband or the father of the child. But I'm just saying that we get the minimum and it's a nightmare. I've never been to child support only to avoid the nightmare of that. So, and because I was very, very lucky that my son's father always tried to talk to me directly and try to, by common sense, help me economically to raise Alan. But I'm just saying that no woman on the normal state of mind will want to have a child in order to get child support. It is ridiculous. I'm not educated and I don't have a child, but I love to work and I love always, you know, to be independent and provide for me and for my son. Right now it's difficult because obviously I want to educate him and raise him ever since I had him. So when I was younger, I was working nights in order to be with him. It's another story. The thing is that it is amazing that who can think that a woman wants child support. And that's why we have kids. So ridiculous. So basically I was into that. So then I start thinking about my son's father and then kind of get me down. Now that I'm sharing it with you, now I feel a little bit better. I took it out of my chest. Okay, so basically for men that are thinking that we want child support and we don't want the fathers, you know, I've been fighting emotionally all these years, ever since my son's father met my son. He met him when my son was 2 years old and 1 month. And I've been fighting emotionally all these years. Since then, for his father to be involved in my son's life and to see him and to contact him, at least call him. And it didn't happen more than just once or twice a year. I was succeeding in that matter, and then he used to see my son once or twice a year, call him maybe a few times a year. So it's not the case, you know, like we do want our kids to have their fathers, but it is kind of difficult, you know, when something is broken, it's broken. It's really hard, you know, it's very hard. I mean, unfortunately it is very hard, but it's never my mother's choice not to let the father to be around the kids. No? I'm just saying there are specific cases that obviously, but if your child's father is normal and is loving your kids, I don't see why they cannot be with your kids. It's just like ridiculous. But anyways, so I hope you enjoy what I share. After the race is done, I'm gonna go to medical to finish the paperwork for my son's insurance. Then I'm gonna go to the grocery store. Then I'm going to go pick up my son at school, and then I'm gonna share his lunch and mine. Okay, so your lunch, corazón, is gonna be almost ready. Alan, you hungry?
Yeah.
As you can see, my son's lunch and mine are very similar. The only difference is that I'm going to eat my rice and green beans with eggs, my son with the dumplings. Thank you so much for watching, and don't forget to subscribe if you enjoy the video.